Can we come around this end? Over in front of this display of the Oscars?
Do we need to come over there?
Over that way, sir.
All right.
What is your birthday, Tom? Did Doc also pick up there a couple of years ago?
I don't know.
Right here. It's Guinea, anyway.
This has been up in the station ever since the Life magazine article came out.
Is that right?
I put the list on display and moves all over the city. For Navy Appreciation Week, it'll go to Pioneer Day, so. That's my grandson. I think you need to autograph that one. We had the TV pulled right on this property. Jeff climbed up in it.
Yeah.
And
that's a bit black.
Yeah, he could have flown up in it.
Thank you.
Well,
of course there.
Yeah, that's all crashed here in Fort Lauderdale. There's your air station here, sir. Where your plane was parked out here a lot. AMI Combs, where you get off, is just about in that area, right in that area. Here's the port you flew over, the torpedo retrieving boats. They picked you up, picked your torpedoes up as you dropped them, the dummy torpedo.
Yeah.
The Coast Guard and the security dogs patrol the base. This here, I put things on board ships a lot, so they can see. We got a famous person here. And one of the photographers here today, Eric Stevens, he took this picture up in Carolina. I'd like to know what you said about telling that.
I forget, but those two girls.
Yeah, that's the one that was shot down, and he's the one that picked up.
There he is, right there. Yeah.
It looks like there. We did it.
Yeah.
We did it.
Yeah, that was nice.
And,
that is great. Alan, tell him about your compass reading.
Mr. President, for about 4.5 years now, I've been keeping the history of this naval air station here in Fort Lauderdale, because I figured if I didn't, the buildings one by one were being torn down. And so I figured somebody had to start doing it, but it wasn't too long afterwards. I had a lot of followers. Like Chief Boatswain's Mate, Stephen Sadella, right here. He's the man that rebuilt these buildings to keep them from falling down. And I'm proud of this man. There's a lot of other people that didn't work here with me, but I don't think anybody put the time in that Steve did to build these buildings.
He's really building me up.
But we're keeping the history here, and Country Town Life magazine had you in the article, and we learned about you. This number one Broward, huh? Maybe there.
Yeah.
One thing I want to show you here. I understood. I understood you did a lot of low flying over Fort Everybody's Navy Section Base. They complained a lot, you know. And I got the drum, I got the picture to prove that. There it is right here.
That's your date when you were there, too, yeah?
Oh, Mr. President, we'd like to.
Can I ask?
Yeah. And Mr. Ben Langley is the gentleman that got that up. Where is Ben? Where are you?
Big Ben.
Big Ben. Hold on there, police officer. Well, Ben Langley. And the work of love that Mr. Ben Langley did, he won't dedicate, give it to you. He's a little bashful, but This is the Navy plaque for Mario. Never one made until the last few years ago, and Ben decided it had to be made. Can we hold it? Hold it so he can get to that.
Spin around this way.
Now, the other thing we can, once I sit down, I have another thing right here. We have an organization we just formed recently called the Naval Air Station Fort Lauderdale Historical Association. And we decided when we make an honorary member, you were going to be number one. So we're so pleased that you came in now. It means Naval Air Station Fort Lauderdale Historical Association awards George Herbert Walker Bush, Ensign, United States Navy Reserve, 1943, President of the United States, and Commander-in-Chief, U.S. Armed Forces, 1992. Honorary membership, number one. This association is dedicated to preserving the history and memory of Naval Air Station Fort Lauderdale, presently the Fort Lauderdale-Hollywood International Airport, as well as the Naval Air Station boat facility, the Fort Lauderdale Navy Section Base, and Fort Lauderdale Coast Guard Station, which were located in Port Everglades during the period 1942-1946. The primary mission of the association is to educate the general public about the very important role that the greater Fort Lauderdale, Florida area performed for the United States of America during World War II, and to provide an environment and camaraderie for the common good of the community and for the future.
Very nice.
Thank you, sir. You're welcome, Mr. President. It's a real honor.
Get somebody to pick up on my
loop here. Can we hold that up a second?
Dave?
Okay.
Great. You all are nice to rally around. Thank you.
I can't tell you how much I appreciate it.
Dave, again.
Good to have you down.
Anyone want to tell me if you can help
us?
$300,000. Thank you. Glad to see you, sir. Thank you. We'll see y'all. I really like it. Thank you.
Thank you.